Good morning, folks. This is Michael on the Graveyard Shift in the wee hours of the night with your daily trivia question. Once again, it's Sunday night, folks. Sunday night into Monday morning. That can only mean one thing. The weekend is over. Time for a brand new week, brand new opportunities. So let's just put both feet on the ground and let's get to it, okay? Shall we? The answer to the previous trivia question was none other than a movie called Fast Times at Ridgemont High. What can I say about Fast Times at Ridgemont High? It is a classic, classic movie. It is hilarious. It's from the early to mid 1980s, and a lot of movies at this time had the same kind of vibe, kind of plot, kind of a feel to them, if you will, that were coming out during this time. Fast Times at Ridgemont High, again, it's an absolute classic movie from 1982. It's considered a coming-of-age comedy drama of sorts. The film chronicles a school year in the lives of a group of teenagers who are desperately trying to make it through high school any way they can and avoid all the troubles, the woes, and certainly all the drama that comes with it. The movie takes place in San Fernando, California in the early 80s. We're kind of a valley girl and surfer life type of vibe, like I was kind of referencing earlier, was going on. It has multiple subplots playing out. There's all kinds of characters. Most notably was the surfer character, played by a very early Sean Penn, one of his early roles, and his name is Jeff Spicoli. And quite frankly, he gets stoned a lot during the movie, smokes a lot of pot. The character does at Fast Times at Ridgemont High. So in addition to Sean Penn, the film marks early appearances by several actors who would go on to become pretty big in Hollywood. And this includes Judge Reinhold, easy for me to say, Nicolas Cage, Eric Stoltz from Spider-Man, Forrest Whitaker from the movie The Butler, Anthony Edwards is in it from Top Gun and the show ER. All of these are their very first appearances ever in a movie. And if you blink, at some point in the movie, you'll miss some of these characters for sure. The movie also features one of the most iconic and kind of underground scenes ever replayed in movie history. And, of course, I'm talking about the pool scene with Phoebe Cates. And it's got the Cars song Love in Stereo playing in the background to it. And if you've never seen this scene, you should check it out. That's all I'm going to say. Phoebe Cates, the pool scene, Fast Times, Ridgemont High. You can check it out on YouTube if you want to. There's actually a loop on YouTube where they slow it down in slow motion. But that scene, in and of, if not for anything else in the movie, that scene in and of itself made the movie a classic hit. It also put like the Cars on the map with that song, and everybody else that was Phoebe Cates became a star overnight. It's just, oh my gosh. So in the end of the movie, everybody makes it out okay at Fast Times at Ridgemont High, to include good old Jeff Spicoli, who even gets a visit to his house by his history teacher, known as Mr. Hand. It's Mr. Hand, the great, great role played by the character Mr. Hand. He gives him a private tutor lesson at the end to make sure that he graduates from high school, even stoned out of his mind. Some cool geek factoids about Fast Times at Ridgemont High. The movie only had a budget of $5 million. Okay, now think about that. You don't even start out paying actors at $5 million in today's day and age. Okay, so that was the whole budget. Can you imagine that these people were probably working for like chump change? And it went on to gross $27.1 million, which is not too shabby with that kind of a budget and bringing in that kind of a money back in 1982. It also got hooked on an HBO loop. I remember watching it many, many times on HBO, which helped to generate some revenue as well, I'm sure. The director of the movie got all of his ideas and all of his characters by actually going undercover at an actual high school called Claremont High School, which is located in San Diego, and he wrote about all of his experiences. And lo and behold, he had the script for Fast Times at Ridgemont High thereafter. In 2005, I found this to be unbelievable. The film was selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by the Library of Congress as being, quote, culturally, historically, and aesthetically significant. I'm not sure what kind of contributions this movie made to society. But hey, there's always the Phoebe Cates pool scene, so maybe that had a lot to do with it. Some people who were considered, check this out, who were considered for and even offered roles for the movie Fast Times at Ridgemont High in 1982, and for one reason or another they didn't get it or they either turned it down, include, check this out, Tom Hanks, Justine Bateman, who turned the offer down to go work on a show called Family Ties, Matthew Broderick from Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and Jodie Foster. Can you imagine? All of those people turned down roles for Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Classic, classic movie. I was doing research for this trivia question. I just instantaneously went to Amazon and added this to my shopping cart in the bargain bin. It's really, it's a must-have for your movie catalog for sure, folks. If you don't have it, pick it up. Check it out. Cool, cool movie. Fast Times at Ridgemont High. All right, folks, off we go. Run into a brand new week with a brand new trivia question. August is almost over, folks. This is the last week before classes start, so have some fun this week for sure. For August 15th, here we go, on this day in 1914, with what began as an effort to move commerce more quickly, this opens to traffic for the first time, which was one of the largest construction projects of all time, where U.S. engineers moved nearly 240 million cubic yards of earth and spent close to $400 million constructing it. That's all the clues I'm going to give you, folks. Go figure it out. Do some research. Have fun. Have a marvelous Monday and a great week. Thanks for all you do. As always, you guys are awesome. Peace out, y'all.